Welcome. My name is Kristen Marshall, and on behalf of Father Walsh, Deacon Marty, and our parish community, we would like to thank you for joining us as we celebrate this Easter Sunday. As we listen to today's readings, let us give thanks and rejoice for the risen Christ, remembering to radiate his light to all those we encounter on our earthly journey. Please stand.
Good morning, happy Easter. Awful good to have you here, and good to have those in the parish center and in our chapel as well. And I know we got the people at home who are joining us, both locally here and across the country. We're awful glad to have you. You're part of our parish family as well. So we begin in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
And the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
So my sisters and brothers, this is the day the Lord has made. Let us keep the feast with joy and gladness. And turning our thoughts to the risen Lord, let our voices rise in song.
We
Let us pray. O God, who on this day, through your only begotten Son, have conquered death and unlocked for us the path to eternity, grant, we pray, that we who keep the solemnity of the Lord's resurrection may, through the renewal brought by your Spirit, rise up to the light of life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Peter proceeded to speak and said, "You know what happened all over Judea, beginning in Galilee after the baptism that John preached. How God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and power. He went about doing good and healing all those oppressed by the devil, for God was with him. We are witnesses of all that he did, both in the country of the Jews and in Jerusalem. They put him to death by hanging him on a tree. This man God raised on the third day and granted that he be visible, not to all the people, but to us, the witnesses chosen by God in advance, who ate and drank with him after he rose from the dead. He commissioned us to preach to the people and testify that he is the one appointed by God as judge of the living and the dead. To him, all the prophets bear witnesses that everyone who believes in him will receive forgiveness of sins through his name." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, for his mercy endures forever. Let the house of Israel say, "His mercy endures forever." The right hand of the Lord has struck with power. The right hand of the Lord is exalted. I shall not die, but live, and declare the works of the Lord. The stone which the builders rejected has become the cornerstone. By the Lord has this been done. It is wonderful in our eyes. A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, do you not know that a little yeast leavens all the dough? Clear out the old yeast so that you may become a fresh batch of dough, inasmuch as you are unleavened. For our paschal lamb, Christ, has been sacrificed. Therefore, let us celebrate the feast, not with the old yeast, the yeast of malice and wickedness, but with the unleavened bread of sincerity and truth. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Amen. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
On the first day of the week, Mary of Magdala came to the tomb early in the morning while it was still dark and saw the stone removed from the tomb. So she ran and went to Simon Peter, and to the other disciple whom Jesus loved and told them, "They have taken the Lord from the tomb, and we don't know where they put him." So Peter and the other disciple went out and came to the tomb. They both ran, but the other disciple ran faster than Peter and arrived at the tomb first. He bent down and saw the burial cloths there, but did not go in. When Simon Peter arrived after him, he went into the tomb and saw the burial cloths there, and the cloth that had covered his head, not with the burial cloths, but rolled up in a separate place. Then the other disciple also went in, the one who had arrived at the tomb first, and he saw and believed. My sisters and brothers, the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. You know, I think you'd agree that, you know, as humans, we constantly have to be reminded of things, have to be reminded. We have so much stuff going on in our brains that we need reminders. And so we get the text message from pharmacy, you come pick up your prescription. You get reminded of doctor's appointment. Valvoline sends things, hey, your car's at 4,000 miles, you need an oil change. You know, if you're a kid, you know, teachers say, hey, you got the test tomorrow, remember? Or you're in college, hey, next week that paper's due, just remember. So we constantly have to be reminded because we have just so much stuff going on. And I think Easter is a great yearly reminder of three really important things, okay? So number one, you are loved by God. You are loved by God. All human beings are loved by God. And there's nothing that will stop God from loving us. No matter what we do, God will continue to love us. And it's one of those things that lots of times people will say to me, isn't all this religion stuff just about being a good person? Just about being a good person. And I think for some faiths it is. But for Christians, it's that, but it's more than that. Because God wants a relationship with us. He wants a loving relationship with us. And that really is why he went to the cross on Good Friday, to die for our sins and show us the extent of his love for us. So that whole idea of relationship is what he really, really wants. Two, Easter reminds us that life is short. It is very, very short. Jesus only lived 33 years. And even if we live to 103, it's a very short period of time. This is not our home. We are simply visitors here. We are passing through. Our real home is with God. That's where we came from. That is God's intent that we return there. And I often think to myself that it's a, you know, our mission here is to make this world a little bit more Christ-like. And sometimes if we ever can kind of interiorize this idea that life is very short and my mission here is short-lived and it's to make this world more Christ-like, it really helps our decision-making process. Huh? Because we stress about a lot of things in this life. We stress out and we put a ton of adrenaline into things, and it's really worth asking the question, will God care about this? Will he ask me about this when I die? And if he won't, then it probably doesn't deserve our adrenaline and our stress. Now, if it's important to God, then it ought to be important to us. But interiorizing this whole idea of the shortness of life and what our mission is here can really take a lot of the stresses out of our life. Three, Easter reminds us that all suffering is temporary, very temporary. So, you know, on Good Friday when we had our 6 p.m. liturgy here, I talked about, You know, 30 years ago, I was in a church somewhere around the Newark area. It was an old church, been there for decades. And when you first walked in, right on a pillar, they had a crucifix and the corpus, the wooden cross of Jesus. Right at your face level was his feet and the lower part of his shin. And what it was very dark in color. It was very stained. And it just represented thousands of people through the decades who would walk in there and touch that statue with all their pain. And they were begging for miracles. They were stressed. They were pained. And it was the cumulative oils and the sweat of their hand that turned that wood a stained darker color. And it is good to remind us that in this life, we just got to hold on. And we're all going to have moments that we feel we want to grab that statue. We just got to hold on and hold out. Because eternal life doesn't involve suffering. And that's one of the beauties of the resurrection. You know, when Mary Magdalene came and she saw the empty tomb, that opened for us. You know, the reason Jesus went through this whole thing is so that we would know what happens at the end of our life. That he has a deep desire for us to join him in heaven, where there'll be no more pain and suffering. So we just have to hold on and hold out and know that suffering will end. And so it's a great reminder to us today, huh? Easter's a great reminder. You are loved by God, and he wants that relationship with you. Life is short, and when we interiorize that, it can really de-stress our lives with things that we get wrapped around the axle with that really aren't important. And that all suffering is temporary. Just got to hold on and hold out. Well, I'm awful, awful pleased that you're here. I know some of you may be back for the first time. We're really trying to keep people safe here. And so I just want to talk a little bit about how we're going to receive communion, okay? So what we try to do is we have ministers, we have ambassadors here who will kind of guide you when to come up to communion. And I'm very, very grateful to them. They've done a super job over the last year here. And we have communion ministers that will be at the head of the aisles. One will be in the back here down the parish center. Deacon Marty will be down to see you. When you come up, if you can have your mask on, we'll have ours on, and just make that little basket with your hand, and then we're going to drop the host in your hand. And then if you could just move off to the left or right, 6 feet or 12 feet, little markings on the tile, and then just take off your mask, receive the host, put the mask back on, and return by the side. And those of you down in the parish center, you see that gray tile there that's in the middle of the parish center? You're just going to walk up that gray tile and then go back by the sides. Now, Deacon Marty, he's got gluten-free hosts for you down in the parish center if you need one. I've got gluten-free hosts here. I'll be standing right here today. If you need a gluten-free host, just come on over to my line. More than happy to give you one. And then also, sometimes people just want a blessing instead of receiving communion, and we are more than happy to give you a blessing. If you come up with your arms across your chest, we are more than happy to give you a blessing. So one of the things, remember, we do on Easter is we renew our baptismal promises, okay? So my dear sisters and brothers, through the Paschal mystery, we have been buried with Christ in baptism so that we may walk with him in a newness of life. And so now that our Lenten observance is concluded, let us renew the promises of holy baptism by which we once renounced Satan and his works and promised to serve God in his holy Catholic Church. And so I ask you, do you renounce Satan?
I do.
And all his works?
I do.
And all his empty show?
I do.
Do you renounce sin so as to live in the freedom of God's children?
I do.
And do you renounce the lure of evil so that sin may have no mastery over you?
I do.
And do you renounce Satan, the author and prince of sin?
I do.
And do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth?
I do.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, suffered death and was buried, rose again from the dead, and is seated at the right hand of the Father? And do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting?
I do.
And the Almighty God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has given us new birth by water and the Holy Spirit, and bestowed on us forgiveness of our sins, Keep us by his grace in Christ Jesus our Lord for eternal life. Amen. As we give thanks for the risen Christ living among us, we petition the Father to hear our prayers.
For the church, that we may radiate the light of Christ each day and confidently live as daughters and sons of God amid uncertainty, trusting our Lord and his plan for us, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who thirst for something more in life or who are confused or doubting their faith, that they may experience the risen Lord and discover the truth through God's love. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the baptized and all who became members of our church last evening, especially Rose Kochefeld, Roman Hansen, Dakota Claw, Sean Swint, Terry Glazebrook, Sylvia Kukin, and James Russell, that they may be faithful witnesses to Christ in word and deed. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For healing of hearts and relationships, that the risen Lord will open the path to reconciliation and healing amongst families, communities, and co-workers. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are away from home this Easter, particularly members of the military and those working on the front lines of the coronavirus, that God will protect and guide them home safely. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are ill, confined to home, and can't be with their extended families this Easter, and the petitions in our parish prayer book, that they may encounter the risen Lord who brings hope and healing. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
for those who have died, especially Barbara Noonan, wife of John Noonan, Mary David, mother of Ted and Stephen David, and also those who have died from COVID-19 and all members of our families and friends who have gone before us. May the risen Lord greet them with love and mercy and grant them the happiness of his kingdom. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. And loving and merciful God, who raised your Son to new life, we ask that you hear the prayers we offer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And one of the important parts of our yearly budget is our Easter collection. So I just want you to know how much I'm grateful for your, online giving, your text to give, envelopes, Dropbox. Thank you very much. And I know many of you at home are helping us as well. And I want you to know that we're very grateful to you. Pray that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Exultant with paschal gladness, O Lord, we offer the sacrifice by which your church is wondrously reborn and nourished through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
And let us give thanks, O Lord our God.
It is right.
And it's truly right and just, our duty and our salvation at all times, to acclaim you, O Lord, on this day, but above all, to laud you yet more gloriously when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying, he destroyed our death. By rising, restored our life. And therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory, as they acclaim. Indeed, holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness, and make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." And in song, we proclaim the mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Edward our Bishop, Howard our Bishop Emeritus, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. And deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we wait the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
The kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours.
And Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace in unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen."
And the peace of the Lord with you always.
Let us offer each other a sign of Christ's peace.
Take away the sins of the world.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you.
Let us pray. Look upon your church, O God, with unfailing love and favor, so that, renewed by the Paschal mysteries, she may come to the glory of the resurrection. Through Christ our Lord. Awful good to have you out today. Thank you, and thank you for joining us on our live stream. It's a beautiful Easter day. Hope you get a chance to enjoy that with your family. I hope we've done a good job of staying connected with you over this past year. Our two main communication methods are these Tuesday updates and Thursday constant contacts. So if you're not receiving those, call our office or give us a shout out. We'll get you connected so that we can help you make sure you know what's going on here, okay? If you're new here or new watching our live stream, looking to engage or re-engage in your faith, we'd love to help you. It doesn't really matter where we're at in the journey. Sometimes, our parish family here, one of the things that makes us a strong community, we got some people here just got their toe in the water on faith. Others been doing it a long time and got it down pretty well. That makes for a great community. And so it doesn't matter where you're at in that spectrum. If we can help you get engaged or re-engage, you let us know. Drive-through communion, we got it today. Maybe you were watching. When we finish, just kind of get in your car. If you can hold off till 11:30, we're going to do 11:30 to 12:30 right out here in front. Come in Upper Loudoun Road. But if you can help our people here to allow them to get out of the parking lot before you come. And then just have your mask. If you got a contact tracing form, that's great. If not, we'll have some out there for you. But we want you to receive the Eucharist on Easter, okay? Next weekend, we're going to go back just to the 5 o'clock Saturday night, 10 o'clock on Sunday. Now, if more people show up and after a couple weeks we see we need another mass, we're happy to add another mass. But next week we'll go back to 5 o'clock on Saturday, 10 o'clock on Sunday. Always appreciate over here, of course our exit out here is closed because of the construction. So the folks over here on the chapel side, if you can exit through the main doors, I'd be grateful we can keep you safe that way. Parish Center, thank you. You're very good about turning those chairs so we know which chairs to sanitize. Appreciate you doing that. And we certainly, on behalf of Deacon Marty, enjoy today. This is the resurrection. This is what it's all about. Enjoy it with your family and friends. Hope you get a chance to relax a little bit today. A little thought for the day. Life's greatest joy is the prospect of heaven. Life's greatest joy is the prospect of heaven. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And the Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Go and proclaim the gospel by your lives.
Thanks be to God.